going on, everyone? I got a brand new movie review for you guys today, and today I'm discussing The Chaperone. If you guys are new here, well, consider hitting that like and subscribe button for tons of early movie reviews and geeky content over on this channel. Plus, you guys can also go over to Sandwich on Films for ways to see films early. Chaperone takes place in the early 1920s. A Kansas woman finds her life forever changed when she accompanies a young dancer on her fame-seeking journey to New York City. This movie actually had quite a bit more to that than just the synopsis, but I was kind of intrigued with this film. I mean, it does have Haley Lou Richardson in it, who I am a big, massive fan of. She is one of my favorite actresses working today. And in fact, one of the main talents, whenever she shows up in something, I'm kind of there day one just for the fact of it being her. I think she's a very up-and-coming talent that has a lot of stuff to give to the screen. And this film is no, by any means, it is because of her performance that this film works on its levels. In fact, this film does feel like a TV movie, and in fact, lacks a lot of different types of depth. Even when it comes down to the storytelling and script, I actually kind of felt bored. And that's not saying I like period pieces. I'm not against them. In fact, Colette was one of the most underrated films of last year. And this film did feel like the same pacing and tone of Colette, but just middled down to a TV movie. And in fact, just felt like a very predictable story that should not have been predictable. This is a very interesting, based on a true story character about Louise Brooks, Haley Rue Richardson's character, who I am very fascinated with in general. Now, the story does contain a lot of those TV movie aspects. There is some nice fun to be had in this movie. I really enjoyed the score and that some of the period set pieces that they do take us to, and even some of the journeys that, say, the character that Elizabeth McGovern has, who plays Norma, I thought she gave a really good performance. One of the main leads in this film as being the chaperone to Louise Brooks' character, and the subplot that she actually happens to go on, I think, will actually relate to other people's stories. But honestly, if it wasn't for her performance and Haley Richardson's, I would have completely checked out of this movie. They were the two main leads that really kept me invested into the story. Between some of the dialogue that actually seemed a little bit stagnant and at times really bland, it kind of sucks saying that because I do like my period pieces. I like being sucked into this world, but it never gripped me and sucked me in. Coming from the writers and directors of Downton Abbey, it actually felt a little bit more disappointing to see this happening. By no means, this is a horribly made film. There's a decent score to it. There's some nice period piece fun to be had with it, and two excellent performances overall. But even though the film does feel like a TV movie, it's hard for me to tell you to rush out to the theaters and go see this in limited release when there are tons of other great movies that you should be checking out. That said, I'm gonna give The Chaperone a C-. You know what your guys' thoughts are on The Chaperone. Are you guys excited for this film or are you not? I'm curious to hear your guys' thoughts on this one. Make sure you guys hit that like and subscribe button right down there so you guys never miss a review. But until next time, stay classy.